The Imitation of Christ is a Christian devotional work written probably by the German-Dutch priest Thomas Kempis, although it was originally published anonymously in the first quarter of the 15th century. Thomas was a member of a religious movement called Devotio Moderna, literally modern devotion, which had begun in the Netherlands about 50 years earlier and which emphasized piety, humility and simplicity. It died out shortly after the beginning of the Protestant Reformation. The Imitation of Christ consists of four sections. The first three concentrate on the inner life, getting rid of earthly distractions, maintaining faith in eternal life, and enduring suffering. The last section focuses on the Eucharist, but with the continued intention of promoting inwardness. Each section represents a development of the previous one. So section one counsels repentance and a meditation on one's own intrinsic worthlessness. Section 2 advocates purity of heart and contemplation of the cross. Section 3, the longest, is an extended dialogue with Jesus, in which Jesus resembles an abbot dispensing advice to a novice for spiritual advancement. Section 4 shows the way to assured salvation through the Eucharist. Naturally, the final section is the climax. Roman Catholics in this period took very seriously the notion of transubstantiation. The idea that when the bread and wine have been consecrated by the priest, they literally become the body and blood of Jesus. Of course, that's still the official doctrine of the Roman Catholic Church, the difference being that nowadays we live within a context of scientific skepticism, and it's likely that most believers can't completely detach from that. What makes the Imitation of Christ so interesting is its pervasive gloominess and its low estimation of human nature apart from God's redeeming grace. It's difficult to imagine anyone writing a similar work today. Most modern Christian devotional works tend to want to meet humanism halfway. Yes, we've got a lot of faults, but while it's nothing, a little humility and prayer won't cure. For Thomas Kempis, on the other hand, the path is long, unhappy, and exceptionally difficult. Which should remind us that although we often talk about Christianity in the singular, it would be perhaps more accurate to talk about Christianities, on the grounds that parts of the religion often possess distinctive features, indexing them to history and geography. Medieval Christianity was exceptionally interesting. Modern versions can seem rather anemic by comparison. The Imitation of Christ is the most widely read and translated Christian text outside the Bible. It also influenced Hindu and Muslim theologians. The strange thing is that despite its somber, almost relentless pessimism, or perhaps because of it, it's not repellent. Far from it. Unless your view of human nature is incurably sunny, maybe.